we are speaking about coffee roasting. What is a coffee roasting? So we can try to give a definition of this process. It's a heat treatment with heat transfer from a coffee roaster, that it's a machine built to roast coffee, to the green coffee bean. This heat transfer to the bean is made by using especially three ways how to transfer heat to the bean. So the first of all, and the most important one that we have during roasting with the modern coffee roasters, is convection. Convection, it means that I transfer heat to the bean using hot air. This hot air goes all around the bean in the roaster, and we will see at the end of this lesson the roasting process with the Ikawa Coffee Pro sample roaster, that it's totally convective, convection roaster, and I transfer the heat into the bean evenly all over around the bean, so that let the heat goes inside evenly and uniformly. The second one, so the first one is this one. The second one is conduction. Conduction, mostly used in the traditional drum roasters, is the heat transfer to the bean through just a single point of the bean that is going to be in physical contact with the heat source. In this case, you know, this is the section of a drum, of a roaster. The drum rotates, for example, in this direction. I have the here the green beans inside the roaster. I can have, for example, the heat burner in the bottom part of the machine, especially in the small roasting machines. In this case, the drum, this is the drum, will have a very high temperature, and the bean that is going to be in touch with the drum will absorb heat from the drum just in the point where the bean will be in touch with the drum. So seeing something more large, this is for example the drum, hot drum, so in this point I will have a heat transfer to the bean, but only in one point. So you can easily understand that for have a uniformity roasting process and a uniform heat transfer to the bean, the best way how to transfer it is the convection. A little bit of conduction could be useful to let the coffee be more developed in roasting, and at the end to have a better cup profile, especially for espresso brewing method. The roasting process could be divided in, especially for the time of the roasting, in fast, regular, and slow. Fast roasting process usually is the roasting process that is done in a time that it's less than 5 minutes. Regular roasting process, it's between 10 and 20 minutes. And then we have the longest roasting processes that are up to 25 minutes. That makes a roasting defect that it's called baked coffee. The bean at the end is not evenly roasted, but if this is a section of the roasted bean, I will have the inner part, the core of the bean in baked, that will be black. So it means burn. Outside maybe I have a beautiful brown color for filter for espresso, but inside will be burned. Everything that has a darker color in coffee that is produced during the roasting process will be into the cup bitter and burnt aroma. So it's important to avoid this kind of situation. In opposite, when I have a fast roasting process, what happens? That it's too fast, so at the end I have a very good roasting color at in the external part of the bean, but here inside will be underdeveloped, under-roasted, so too light. I don't have light roasting color, so I don't let the coffee being roasted evenly and uniformly during the roasting process. Regarding roasting, it's important also to underline the most important physical and chemical changes between the green bean, so before roasting, and the roasted bean. So here I have in between the roasting process. So what happened during this phase? So for sure, and probably you know, the green bean before roasting is just green color. At the end of the roasting color, I changed the color of the bean, so it became brown. So this is one of the most important ones. As you can see also from my drawing, the volume of the bean expands. So at the end, I have an increasing volume that could be between 50 and 100%. Then I have a loss in weight. For sure, I lose the moisture of the bean, that usually it's around 8-12.5%, so I lose water, but I lose also organic material, volatile aromas, and also CO2. So the loss in weight could be between 15 and 20%. From a chemical point of view, what happened during roasting? The most important chemical reaction that occurred during roasting is the Maillard chemical reaction, caramelization, that also it's important to develop caramelization, to develop the aroma in the beans, and this tracker degradation. So all these chemical reactions and chemical degradation, what will give to the bean? Especially a lot of aroma volatile compound. I will end just drawing a typical roasting profile that is visualized in a roaster. It means that here I have time. Here I have temperature. I will say, for example, typical roasting profile for filter coffee could be around 10 minutes. Okay. The final temperature depends a lot from the roasting technology, the type of bean. I will say, just to give a draft idea, we can say 200 Celsius degrees. So this is could be the final point of my roasting process. I will start the roasting at 170 Celsius degrees. There is immediately a drop in temperature, a turning point. The temperature goes up until ending. This is called turning point. So where my bean temperature profile from descendant became ascendant. A certain point here during the roasting curve, I will have the first crack. That is a popping. It means the physical destroying of the internal cells of the bean. And then the end. The end, it means when I choose the right roasting color for the coffee that I'm roasting and for the brewing method that I'm going to use. And also briefly, and so we can say, we can divide the roasting process in three phases, main phases. So the first one is drying. Then I have the proper roasting phase. And at the end, what happened? So I have beans at 200 Celsius degrees, I have to cool it down. So it means cooling. That it's important, that should be less than 5 minutes to preserve the quality of the bean, to do not have any baked effect into the cup, and to stop the roasting process at the right roasting degree. If I'm a roaster, what I have to avoid during roasting process? especially the roasting defects. The most common one could be tipping, then facing, and then scorching. I don't want to go so in detail now on these defects, but just to let you know that all these three defects bring to the roasted bean something black. And as I already told you, everything that is black in a roasted bean, it means that it will be very bitter in the cup and with burnt aroma.